Hello, everybody. This presentation was supposed to be given by one of our partners working at TF1 Régie. His name was Fabrice Mollier, so he was not able to attend the meeting today. And as one of his partners, Orange, I will make the presentation on his behalf, but my speech is more probably the point of view of an operator working in France than a channel. There is no real technical innovation in my presentation. It's more about business innovation. Addressable TV market is something which is not new, but the way you address this issue according to countries and the rules of the game in these countries would be obviously different, which is why I need to introduce, for those who are not French, what is really the playing field. So at the heart of the, at the core of the slide, you have all the channels, which basically leave, at least the free channels, from the ad they sell to brands, which are on the left-hand side. These channels pay a French broadcaster to broadcast the TV, so that's TDF. That's another money which flows from the TV channels to this TV broadcaster. And although a lot of French households now enjoy TV through the telcos or the cable cos, I suppose that the money who flows from the channels to Télédiffusion de France is about the same because that's fixed cost. And now you have the four ISPs or telcos, Orange being one of them, who pay the French channels to have a TV business model flying on top of their network. The business model of TV for these players is the following. We pay these free channels to get audience on our setup boxes. And this audience, we are able to monetize it by selling premium TV and be paid for this activity, or to sell VOD. Unfortunately, of course, the battlefield evolves through time. These three channels have a strong competitor in France, like in the US, which is coming from the internet players, of course. And each year they come back to us and say, well, we need to be paid more than the year before because we have more services and we earn less in terms of audience business. And of course, the premium TV and the VOD business has to face the competition also with other types of global OTTs, and the margins on this type of business is declining, which is why channels, free channels, and telcos have a common goal to work together, which is how can we bring, although we are on the different side of the market, how can we bring addressable TV to these brands? And the situation is, of course, a bit more complex compared to other countries where you have players who are both broadcasters and channel editors. So what we did with TF1 started from the fact that, of course, operators can track a lot of data. Thanks to the setup box, we know at any time what is the program that a household is watching. We know what are the ads, whatever the channel is, that can be seen, which is something also important. And of course, we can target advertisement if the business model can be implemented based on profiles rather than broadcast the same message to all households. One key principle in France, which is quite important and which is part of the rules of the game we have to play with, is the privacy principle, which are probably harder than in any other countries in the world. So we started working as Orange with TF1. We partnered for several proof of concepts. TF1 is a one of the big, if not the biggest, group of channels in France, free channels, living on audience. But the objective, of course, is to go and to run this business not as something which is exclusive between Orange and TF1. We are not a big market like the US. And of course, we want to have all the other channels and all the other telcos working with the same type of business model. So instead of telling you exactly from the start what we've done technically, here is what TF1 presented to the brands with whom they're working. We can do geo-targeting. Basically, with our set-top box, we are able to target a block of houses. And we make sure the ad can only be watched, for example, in eligible zones. So you have a brand who is, for example, only present in Lille or Paris, then it will be broadcasted only to these households. We can add information according to the home address. So again, if you live in one part of France and another household live in another part, you will have some additional information correlated to, describing you, for example, what is the nearest shop associated with the brand, which can be interesting for the customer. We can also, and that's again for the question related to privacy, we are not able, even if we alias and we anonymize the household, we are not able, although we know, to tell for a given household what is the revenue or how many people live in this household to the channel. That's not possible for privacy reasons, at least without the consumer consent. And I, for the time being, I believe that the consumer consent will not be given very often for this type of data. But we are able to know, because that's something that is rather public, that in this area of the town, it's rather people who will like Twingo, small houses, whereas in this other area of the town, it will be more Mercedes or let's say high upper range cars. Okay, so that's not exactly the same type of data you're manipulating, but that's one way to address the same type of need for the brand. So again, we are able to adapt according to the area, the type of product. Here is an example with Renault, so one single brand with two types of cars. Last but not least, we also help the brands to and TF1 to have something which is a bit innovative, I believe, which is we are able to count the number of times an ad has been seen on a screen on the live TV program. By the way, whatever the channel is, so it doesn't matter if it's a channel belonging to the TF1 group or if it's one of its competitors. We know, for example, that the Coca-Cola brand has been seen by this household, whatever the channel, for the last 3 weeks, for 9 times. And let's assume that Coca is only interested to make sure that everybody is close to 9, above 9. That doesn't bring any value. But if this household is at 5, it brings value to try and push the ad up to 9. So that's what we do with catch-up. At any time a catch-up from TF1 is asked to by the customer, we send the number of ads, the number of times the ad has been seen, Coca-Cola in this example that I gave. And if it's above 9, then it will not be Coca-Cola. If it's 5, it will be Coca-Cola who will be sent, and Coca-Cola will pay for that. All these ads, business cases or all these POCs have been run so far on non-linear TV. So basically the catch-up, and when it will be live, the start-over service. And we are working now, and I will make some comment in my first learnings about how to move forward with the live TV. So our first learning is that, we want to remain very cautious as an operator, and we had, because it was on our set-top box, to make sure that the customer was not a bit skeptical about what we were doing about data privacy. So we explained very carefully to several 100,000 customers what we wanted to do with them. And the level of opt-in was very good. So that was quite good news, because the business case would not fly if, for example, in the end, most people refused to this opt-in issue that we had to solve. So the trade-off between better ads and not more than the number of ads that people have have today is something which is a good balance for the customer. Second thing that was more on TF1 side, there is a business model also for brands, as long as the customer base is there. So that was were the two pieces of information that we wanted to make sure through this POCs. As I mentioned, our POCs are performed for catch-up only or for start-over. Why? It's because it enabled us to move very fast without burning too much cash with TF1 and Orange. It's a simple solution, and there is no complexity to transform this POC into something which is commercial without the whole ecosystem. By whole ecosystem, I mean other group of channels and other telcos. But my understanding from the feedback we've got from Group M6, from France Télévisions, from Group Canal, is that all French channels are eager to move forward with this type of solution on catch-up and start-over. What will be more difficult to tackle is that with this type of players, with this type of battlefield that I describe, the live TV will be more complex to address, because that's a lot more expensive to roll out than for catch-up and non-linear TV. But anyhow, we intend to have a first try for live TV in 2017, at least within our network, so Orange and several channels, that we will communicate upon to other players in France, as we believe that as the leader on the market, we need to open the gates, and we hope that everything will follow, and that we will be able to break the different barriers that we have to tackle with for live TV. And that's it. Thank you.
Thank you. My question is about the opt-in that you were talking about. The opt-in? Yeah. Can you share the percentage of people that were opting in for that action and the way you collected it? I mean, how you asked the users to opt-in? Thank you.
We basically said to the users that they will be, we will not share really customers' data. As you can understand, we just share the address, and by the way, we don't really give the address, we just give the region. And we tell them that we just count the number of ads. So that's very, very, it's not, as I said, really sensitive issue. So this, which is why we were able to enjoy something around 50% opt-in, which makes the situation relevant. I believe that with this type of data, we can even try and work and persuade with the CNIL that maybe it will be more an opt-out solution that can be handled.
All right, hopefully. And I understand the way to ask, it was through Orange, I mean through the whole TV.
Yeah, it's Orange speaking to our own customers, yep. It's not TF1. But we said that it would be shared, if I may say, with TF1, although it is fully anonymized. And in fact, there is an interface between Orange and TF1 in this case, but it's basically the same with all channels for catch-up or for other non-linear TV programs, where we give an address to TF1 for the ad server. with some characteristics, exactly the type of data that I mentioned. But let's say on Monday and on Tuesday, we serve the same household, it will be a different address that we will give with the same characteristics. So TFA is not able to understand that it is the same customer from day one to day two. We take care of this. We just give the parameters we don't. Okay.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, thank you.